This is a USB hub right here. My USB camera plugs in to the USB hub because you only have one USB port on your tablet. So it's the same kind of configuration that you have with your camera, except for mine has a USB on the end. You have miles and miles of cable, so I have attached mine to the bottom of the machine. As you can see, it goes here and down underneath my quilt. So I've just added some like channel guides to manage my cable, rubber banded here, put a hook to hold it on. Now let me go to the other side of my machine. As you can see, there's the rest of the cable coming around to the front of my machine, and there is the camera. Sometimes I have it mounted here in front, depending on what my pattern looks like, and sometimes I have it mounted here on the side, so that will hold the camera. So I'm either seeing the left side of my pattern, or if I have a very undulating, complicated matter, I can see underneath it as it moves along. And how I visualize that on my tablet, here, let me move this over under my fabric. Okay, as you can see, my hopping foot is over some of the pattern, and let's see if I can get it to show up. That's just the camera feature on my Surface Pro. And I very quickly switched to some red thread so that it could be seen on the blue background. And this is, by the way, not quilting fabric. It's a tablecloth that I got from the Goodwill. So I probably need to tighten up those stitches just a little bit. But it does allow me to see what's going on underneath my quilt. Let's see. Yep, there's some more stitching. Oops. There we go. And actually, tension isn't that bad. It's because the fabric itself is so heavily woven. It's not a tight weave like you'd find in 100% cotton. But anyway, so that's my system. There's the camera. This is how I've mounted my USB hub on top of my machine, because as I said before, the Surface Pro only has one USB port, and I'm needing two. And depending on what else I decide to attach to my machine, I may need three or four USB ports. Hope it helps.